Hey everybody, welcome back to StarCraft, and we got...
Amon is beyond any foe we have faced. If we do not act soon, he will devastate the entire sector.
We have shit to do. Okay, so for this one, I'm going Void Rays just because they're fun. I mean, I was kind of avoiding doing Void Rays because now it's just going to be Air Death Fleets for now on in this LP, let's be honest. But, well, there'll be some variation, I'm sure, at some point. Most important thing is Void Ray. Everything else literally doesn't matter. Nothing else matters. We're just building one single unit. And, let's go to the core interface here. Alright. I use Orbital Simulator once again. You do whatever the fuck you want. I mean, either of these is fine. They're both good, but I just like Orbital Simulator. Solar Alliance, pretty good. Deploy Phoenix, pretty important. And then I use Guardian Shell as well. This is just for the time being. You can go to Reconstruction Beam if you want, but these units I have are so cheap that I don't care. I'm also going to put this into Shield Recharge instead of Construction Time, just because I like how fast they regenerated out of combat, so it's kind of nice. Alright. Let's get the show on the road, I guess. I mean, to be honest, your choices in this matter don't matter.
The darkness within calls for the blood of Malash. Now is the hour of my ascendance. Let Rakshir commence!
The rite of Rakshir has begun. From this moment, only Alarak and Malash are allowed to engage each other in combat directly. One must overpower the other and reach the pit of sacrifice. There, the victor will stand as the new leader of the Tal'Darim, and the loser's life will be forfeit.
They appear quite evenly matched.
This is true. However, from what I have learned, Rakshir allows the champion's supplicants to support them psionically.
Our warriors will be able to aid Alarak. But likewise, the Tal'Darim can assist Malash.
I will ready our forces. Malash will fight ruthlessly to hold on to his power. We must be prepared to do the same.
You guys enjoy, like, hybrids made out of, like, paper mache, right? Because that's what we're doing. That's what this strat involves.
The Tal'Darim will send warriors to aid Malash shortly. We should ensure Alarak has sufficient reinforcements.
Malash is drawing power from the Tal'Darim. Alarak will need the support of our warriors.
Alright, he's doing okay here. They're having like their own little Dragon Ball Z fight or whatever the fuck. But we're going to just make probes.
This warrior awakens.
This is literally the only thing we're going to be doing. For at least the time being, there is an expansion like right here, which we're going to try and take pretty early. I'm also making some zealots. And the reason we make zealots is because I need something to tank. We don't need energizers or anything weird like that. I'm trying to think of anything else. We don't want to actually build too many buildings that aren't void rays for void rays, you know. We're looking for exclusively void rays. Let's get another pile on up. I mean, this is more like, it's kind of like payload. Like, it's kind of what it is. Like, we can't, they're kind of just fighting each other, and we can't do anything about it, but we can just sit beside them and escort them to the fucking, I guess the bomb site, whatever the fuck it is. We should also get some air weapons going, actually. We can just do everything. We can also get another zealot out. I'm almost pretty good just to just start moving out or something, or just make stargates or something. Probably should make the stargates.
My vengeance will not be delayed. Send me your warriors.
What a guy.
Yes, your psionic power courses through me. Move forward, slaves. Kill all who aid Malash. You would do well to remember that I command these warriors, Alarak, not you.
Alright, here's what we're gonna do. We want the expo, so let me just keep that going, first of all. So, we're gonna just put him right down here. Finks is just gonna go ham.
I don't understand how this is possible, but my scanners are detecting high solarite concentrations in the native beasts here. We ought to pursue them. However, I think it's best if we don't inform Alarak of this little diversion. Understood, Hierarch.
Okay, I missed one. Hey, we got the expo! What do you know? Well, I have to just basically use all my abilities, though. That's the unfortunate part. But hey, we got the expo. That's all that matters. We can just keep... There's actually no reason we want to stop producing probes, actually, at this point in time. Because we're just gonna move them over as soon as this base is completed. Actually, you should all be helping. And... oops. Alright, my hotkeys are fucky. And we can make our simulators right away and start mining gas. What an incredible feat. So we're not gonna escort it too much further, because we don't want to actually, like... okay, they're apparently just going on their own, so whatever.
Nexus point. Brothers, attack the firstborn directly.
We must place that in a power field. Under cool.
We have the high ground.
We face the enemy.
Don't want to lose that.
You have full power.
All right, let's go back. Okay, send these guys just with that, and make some more probes. And probably get air weapons out. Because that's... Void Rays excel when you give them lots of air weapons.
Hierarch, I am sensing hybrid. They come to aid Malash.
Amon's harbingers, join our struggle. Fight well, warriors, and you will also ascend into hybrid.
Oh, you lie with such conviction. It is almost admirable.
I don't think we need to use any of this right now. Yeah, now we need to use it. Just because there's a hybrid here. There we go, we don't have to lose. Oh, wait, there's another one here. Wonderful. It doesn't matter, we have Void Rays now. They will melt. And also, you can see that little emergency shield kicking in there. That's quite nice. Alright. These Stargates are kind of producing as much as they can for now. I'm gonna have to make some more Stargates, though. We're going for 4 Stargates, by the way. Because we have enough bases to basically produce that many. And I'll hock you that. We can also make a Forge. That probably wouldn't be the worst idea, either. And we get the 4 just for the shield upgrades, nothing else. Though I probably shouldn't be spending this much money on this stuff. So these units are just like, whatever. Like, we're gonna have enough, trust me, very soon. Oh, we also have these optional objectives that we should probably get to doing pretty soon. And literally, this only Stargate is, or Warp Gate, is like a piece of shit now, so. Alright, let's put some pylons over here, just so... if anyone comes up this ramp, then they're distracted by something at least. Oh, they have Colossus. You can see how much I'm not caring anymore about all this stuff. It's quite a lot of not caring. I mean, you can make it like more zealots or something. But you know what? We just freed up a shit ton of supply, so I'm a happy man. I mean, we're fine with that. Cause the supply requirements on this shit is like ridiculous. Alright, let's chrono these. And fuck you too. There's something else I want to shoot somewhere? No? Okay, I'll just fucking do that. Oh cool, I got that one, even though he was moving. It was anticipated. And probably two more, and then we're done. Alright, that's it for probes. And we need to get the last air upgrade and start doing some other research. You have not enough minerals. And now we're gonna need some more pylons.
I sense more hybrid approaching. Be ready.
Zones are just good for a distraction right now, but it soon won't matter. All right, let's divert slightly and kill some of the these little side areas. They have hybrid here. You know what? Fucking go ham. So we gotta kill this thing, and now you can see that range is kind of starting to kick in a little bit. Phoenix actually counts as pushing the cart, actually. That's fucking great. Alright, let's have this one hotkeyed as well. We are actually running out of gas. I don't know what the hell this is. Oh, is this Solarite? No, but I already have it, so it's fine. Because you can see right here, I have kill the Saiyans. Okay, we can do this beam thing, but I'm gonna save it because we actually have the emergency shields or whatever, so they can't actually kill us right away. I don't even know why we're destroying this base. I think it's just for fun.
My vengeance will not be delayed. Send me your warriors.
So now that we have so many minerals, we can do shit like this. Like, make a fuck ton of whatever the fuck these are, cannons. Whatever, I'm sure this is enough. Oh wait, we actually ran out of minerals.
The Tal'Darim are moving against us from the upper pathway. Prepare our defenses.
Tal'Darim, slaughter the firstborn, and your ascension will be assured.
Where are they?
Bring your forces to me, Artanis. I need their power.
Oh, hey, it's this. The cart moves really, really fast. I keep calling it the cart, but it's like not really a cart. And I'm just gonna eat that Psystorm. Oh, wow. We need more pylons? Fuck.
Hybrid Dominator has appeared. It is on its way to Malash.
I literally do not care. I kind of want to do these optional objectives. I think one of the tips for this mission is you could split your forces, but I'm incredibly lazy. Yeah, there you go. Paper mache hybrid. Oh, hey, here's one of the Nexuses. Yeah, there's also like a little optional objective to kill four Nexuses on the map, so. I mean, if you want to, it's pretty easy to do. Because they're, like, right there. And the more Void Rays you have, like, everything just dies instantly. Because they're overpowered as fuck. Yeah, hybrid Schmybid, or whatever the fuck. And fuck these things. That's why I like Void Rays so much. Alright. I'm gonna go over here and take out this thing. Yeah. Oh, now we got 200 supply, yay. Alright, dealt with.
Locking on to the beast's coordinates. Warping it aboard.
Send me your warriors. Now is not the time for prudence.
Well, I like to kind of divert slightly and then kind of take out a bunch of kind of bases and shit, and then we just continue. We're almost at the supply cap, actually. Like, just completely at the supply cap. Alright, we're gonna divert up and we're gonna go get the other little base there. Yeah, you wanna fuck with me? Yeah, okay, goodbye. And normally what you can do is, you can kinda just let our good friend Phoenix go ham if you want. But we'll do that later. This is gonna get emergency shielded. Yeah, because nothing's gonna die here, because it's like, yeah, we got all the fucking upgrades and everything. That's why this combination is like super overpowered. Hello, Sane Elemental.
Malash grows stronger. Slay his Calderine quickly.
Now I have all of them. My preliminary scans indicate that the solarite deposits are a byproduct of the beast's unusual digestive system.
Are you saying that they're... Wait. Never mind. I do not wish to know.
Don't worry, the probe has emergency shields.
A hybrid behemoth? Be wary, Artanis.
We're at maximum supply. Hey, who would have thought everything dies here in, like, one hit? You know what, we need to kill this probe. Get over here. Because we can make one more- Oh, no, we need to kill two more probes. I'm busy trying to kill my probes. There we go. Alright. I want to find out where the other Nexus is, whatever. Let's just first send, Phoenix in. They just get tank a bunch of damage and have fun. Oh good, they killed him. That means one more... Wait, what? What's the deal with... Why do I have like a little bit more supply than I thought I would? 24. Oh, this guy's right here. He didn't die. That asshole. What was he thinking? Okay, now he's dead. Okay, now we can make one more. Let's just go take out the last Nexus, wherever that is. There's like... I think there's one up here. I mean, we have a Void Ray fleet the size of this.
Send me your warriors.
It's not over here, is it? I don't think it's... Nah, it's definitely not up there. We've taken out, I think, three so far? It keeps trying to, like, push this shit. We gotta have fun.
Our pylon is under attack.
Oh, whatever. Oh no, one lived. Oh, we don't care. Fine, we're just gonna push it to the end, Jesus. Actually, no, it's over here. Actually, wait, this guy's right here. Excellent. Thank goodness for that. I think the last Nexus is over here. We did one there. Ah, yeah, right here. Oh yeah, we got one there. It has to be beside resource centers, I'm pretty sure, actually. Why am I even doing this? I don't even know. It's because I really like Void Rays, I guess. Okay, fine, we're gonna just finish the mission. I technically have already done it before, but whatever. Because this isn't exactly a timed mission, and having a fleet of 20 Void Rays is actually really fun.
Hierarch, hybrid with great power are on their way to Malash.
That's what Phoenix thinks about your hybrid with great power.
Is already one hour. You need a peek to their doom. You are right about one thing, Malash. I will leave. Calderine, by the right of Rakshir, I am your High Lord. Listen and obey. Malash promised you lies. There is no ascension. The Calderine will never be uplifted and become hybrid. Aemon betrayed us. And for this, he must die.
Easy shit. Oh yeah, I missed a Nexus, whatever. Oh no, I destroyed three. Oh, you're supposed to destroy three, not four. So I did get them all, never mind. I definitely supported him with 25. Longest forward push, 26 seconds. Yeah, as I said, it's a easy times.
Alarak, the Tal'Darim have yielded to my authority and the Death Fleet is now under my command. I will use them both to avenge Amon's betrayal.
Do your people believe in this cause, as you do?
What they believe is of little consequence. What matters is that they obey.
You choose to rule differently than I, Alarak. Despite this, we may not only end the violence between our kind, but forge a powerful alliance.
Can we now? My people are vastly different than yours, Hierarch.
We both desire vengeance, and we are both Protoss. Is that not enough? Oh,
very well. Submit to my absolute authority, and we may indeed unite our forces.
Do not test me, Tal'Darim. Amon is a mighty foe. Your people cannot hope to stand alone against him. You will side with me, and together we will send him back to the Abyss.
So you do understand my culture after all. Let us say that for now, we have struck another bargain.
Hierarch, I have powered up a new ship subsystem. You can review it in the Solar Core now.
Have the Tal'Darim accepted the truth of Amon's betrayal?
Some have. Others dare not question my commands.
None wish to declare Rakshir upon you.
Let them. No one can stand in the way of my vengeance. This grows tiring. We have done what we came to do. Set course for Ire, and let us bring this war to Amon.
Do not dare give me orders, Alarak. We will return to Ire only when I believe the time is right.
Let's hope that time comes soon.
Artanis, you should know my fear of the Tal'Darim is not of them now, but what becomes of them if Amon is defeated.
You fear they will never integrate with our society.
They share our blood, but they are not like us. You know in your heart that may never change.
It is true. A great battle may loom on the horizon ahead of us, but it's a risk we must take.
It is a great risk.
The dawn of a unified Protoss requires much. Like the threads of a cloth, we must come together and be stronger because of it.
To think what we've become with their culture influencing us. Changing us.
Yes. We will be changed. And perhaps that is what you fear more than battle. The path ahead is uncharted, Matriarch. Rohanna!
I can see it, Artanis. The truth Amon wishes to hide. While his brethren, the Zelnaga, slumbered through the millennia, Amon and his followers descended upon Ire.
And he uplifted our people. They ruled over us as teachers, as gods.
He changed us, manipulated our essence. But we grew beyond his control. He and his followers fled to Zaris to create the Zerg. The hybrid are the culmination of his efforts. False Zelnaga, created in his image. We must...
Rohanna, this is too dangerous. You cannot go on like this.
I must, Hierarch. It is my duty to know the truth, to bear it. I know now. This is my purpose.
Alright, see what the Assembly Army panel wrote.
Alarak has brought his ascendants into our fold. They are fierce, but strong.
This is what they are right here.
For the betrayed.
So they have a psionic orb, which deals damage to a targeted unit. Or psionic orb, and that's the thing you see right here. He orbed the fuck out, though, so you just explode things and fucking splash damage them. And you also have the ability to reduce target to one life, and you gain energy. It's kind of like the, if you remember, Defilers from StarCraft 1. Except you don't kill the unit, you just reduce it to one life. Which is not a big deal when it comes to shielded units like Protoss, but we're going to stay with the Dark Archons for now. I'm sure you'll see at some point.
Hierarch, what would you ask of us? Do not think what has happened here will spare Alarak from my watchful eye.
I did not expect it to.
If he dares to betray us or takes any action against you, I promise his blood will coat these corridors.
Good. That is what I am counting on.
Alright, unallocated Solarite. Let's see what we got here. Alright, so we got 30, and if you put it down... Oh, we also get Purifier Beam. So, this is the last... Did I get all the... Yeah, I got all the Solarite already. So this is the last row of possibilities that we can have here. And so we have Purifier Beam. We fire a controllable beam that at the surface that fires that does 750, I think 750 total damage, and then plus 150. Or sorry, it's 150. It's 1500 against armored to enemy units and structures over 15 seconds. It's good, I'd say. I mean, for nothing, you know. If nothing else, it is free. It doesn't actually move incredibly fast, and it has no energy it costs. It just has an amazingly high cooldown. It's like, I think, almost twice as much as deploying Phoenix. That's pretty important to note. So it's like a kind of like an ultimate ability, but yeah, it doesn't require any kind of power at all to do. So this happens for 15 seconds, and you have time stop where everything, all the enemy units and structures stop in time for 20 seconds. This also counts for hybrid, I think. I don't think this is that good, just because you need something to follow up on the time stop. And since, like, it's not like you can have static defenses like a bunch of cannons and shit to basically, like, deal with the threat. You have to have, like, a fleet or, like, a bunch of forces, and then they get to basically attack them for 20 seconds. I mean, it's not that incredibly great. I like Purifier being better compared to Time Stop. Especially because it costs 50. Like, it requires another 50 Solarite on top of that. And then there's the last one. Bombards area for 15 seconds. Firing 200 random shots to deal 15 area damage each. That's like, what is it? Like, that's like 3,000 damage, and then, like, plus 30 versus armor. That's like, I guess, like, I don't know. Fuck math. I don't care. That's like 6,000. So it does like more damage than a Purifier Beam, and the area is, I think, kind of okay. It's like you use this if you're like. You have like a choke point, and then you just want to kill everything that's coming through that choke point. I mean, everything will die, even like hybrid and things like that. However, you pay 100 Solarite for the privilege of something with a 300 cost cooldown. To be perfectly honest with you, I think they're both shit. I won't lie. Like, it's. I would rather have the shorter cooldowns, because, like I said, you got Phoenix here. Phoenix can fucking solo, like, hybrids and shit like that, so he's got that shit, you know. You have Reconstruction Beam, where you can make your fleet, like, infinitely more kind of, like, tankable. And then you get this shit, and it's just like, okay, 300... Like, the cooldown's too high for this, for the Solarite cost, so... I wouldn't do that. Anyways, since I have 40 Solarite, I'm just gonna put it into Chrono Surge, and... Maybe I can use that for research or something at some point. I never use it, I know, but whatever. We'll see what I want to do with it. Anyways, you have a warp travel ready, so let's go do that.
The Tal'Darim and Alarak have joined our fight, but we cannot strike against Ire until Amon's armies have been brought low. Mobius Corps is overseeing Amon's hybrid production lab. I will not let this continue. We will go to Revanskar and destroy the station, before Amon can create more of these abominations.
Yeah, I'm gonna actually end it off here before anything else, just because, it kind of knocks me into something. So, thanks for watching, and take care, and see you next time.